Hello, hello! And welcome back as I finally conclusively prove the adage that the more things change, the more they stay the same. In Perfidious, Pete plays Life is Strange. Because apparently it just doesn't matter at all whether my girl Chloe is a blue-haired, pot-smoking punk rock rebel or a dishwater blonde morphine-slurping Stephen Hawking wannabe. The Price is Upstairs bathroom, it's still encrusted with more grime than the inside of a porta-potty after a week at Burning Man. It's always filthy in every universe. This bathroom is going to give you gangrene just for walking into it. Your feet are going to rot off. If you walk in here, God forbid you should come in here barefoot or step foot in this shower. You're going to lose a limb. It's going to have to be amputated. It's amazing Chloe has limbs to be paralyzed, honestly. Just proof that there are some things that even the butterfly effect can't change. And what are we doing up here? We actually came up here to look for some kind of medicine for Chloe.
It's cool.
She needs morphine.
Chloe uses natural medicine too.
Sure, you know, natural medicine, like the good old-fashioned, pure 100% organic morphine she sent us up here to grab. But we came up here to get it, and my real question is, like, if it came out of this bathroom, should we actually be willing to inject this into Chloe? I mean, as encrusted with filth and bacteria as it's gonna be?
I never thought I'd be delivering
morphine. I'm not sure this is safe. Chloe's already gonna have a compromised immune system because of her condition. I don't know if it's okay for us to inject her with anything that came out of this bathroom. I could be murdering my girl. I don't want to murder her. I want her to live. More specifically, I want her to live back in the actual time, not this weird alternate timeline.
I think I look older.
Scott, backlit ourselves into it. You think you look older? So the last day has aged you? Is that what you're saying? Hanging out with your disabled friend for one day has been such a drain on you, Max, that you feel physically... You know, Max, every time I think I'm just starting to get into what you're all about, and putting aside the hipsterism for just a minute, every
Chloe's
time I think about that,
warning anymore.
Then you just do or say something that 100% 180 reverses, changes my opinion. Okay, so Chloe's room is empty, probably because, you know, the stairs were going to be a bit of a problem. Hey, the thing's still on the wall, though. Height chart. Is there a new one to show Chloe's new height where she has been reduced since she's seated most of the time?
We stopped growing up together.
Chloe. Oh, what? Why are we... Aw, that's not cool. These are just Chloe. There's no Chloe and Max. What was different about this past? Why did we stop being friends at such a young age? I don't get it. I mean, we were still friends when we were like 10 because we were over at her house. Some of our marks should still be on this wall. Okay, whatever. Let's sit on Chloe's spool table here and just ruminate for a minute. Just kind of get our bearings.
By this new reality.
Well, maybe you should stop being overwhelmed by it.
I feel so guilty for putting Chloe and her family through this.
Now you feel guilty about the butterfly effect changing things and you not being aware of what they're changing?
But then I see that they're a family again. And who am I to judge?
Good God, Max. You're constantly racked with fucking inner guilt and self-doubt. Couldn't you just for once just... You know what? Just pick a course of action and just roll with it. Fly by the seat of your pants. Take a page from the book of old Chloe and just fucking do something, girl. Who cares if it's the right thing? Stop being
too
so self-incriminating all the time.
From the Prescott Foundation.
Dear Joyce, thank you for keeping me updated on Chloe's condition. I can only imagine the struggle you and William are going through. I'm so sorry that I can't help you with a loan at this time. Like everybody else, I'm underwater with my own medical bills. Please give Chloe a hug and my best wishes. Love, Aunt Dorothy. How come the old Prescotts, who are supposed to
they
be like the philanthropist freewheeling owners of Arcadia Bay, can't help Chloe out?
Again.
Well, it's good that they stashed him up here, because, I mean, if they stuck him in a room, it would sort of be like a fuck you to Chloe. It'd be like, hey, these crutches, maybe you could use them.
Toys? I kind of want to open this and see what's in here.
Well, you know, it's right there. There's no option to open it, apparently.
Chloe always did love stomping around in her boots.
Yeah, well, shoes ain't exactly high on her wardrobe choice these days, are they?
I never heard much about William's brother.
Hi, Bill. Sorry for not staying in touch since the accident. Work has been piling up, and I'm being sent to Salt Lake City to oversee a new parking lot. You have to go where the work is these days. I wish I could have sent you a bigger check, but you know the story. Money is nobody's favorite thing. Maybe I'll see you next spring for a visit. Kiss Chloe and Joyce for me. Hang in there, Billy. Your brother, Aaron. Well, Aaron came through with a little cash. It was nice of him. He can't be making a lot if he's doing like parking lot construction.
At least we never had to hide from Step Douche.
Yeah, he never smacked her upside the head either, but I'm thinking she would probably trade a little rap on the beater for functional legs, Max.
A blue butterfly? I'm sure this is a total coincidence.
It is definitely nothing resembling a coincidence, Max. This game does not have coincidences. We gotta find another blue butterfly and, like, take a picture of it or something. So we got Chloe's medicine. Can we go poke around in Joyce and William's room? What's the picture? Is it still the same?
It's all about you, Arcadia Bay, isn't it?
Fuck Arcadia Bay. I don't give a shit about this pest hole of a town. It's all about my blue-haired girl, Chloe. I gotta save her from herself. Oh, William. Oh, is Joyce asleep?
Oh, Max, it is so nice to have you around.
Really? Even though I just barged uninvited into your bedroom without knocking? It's so nice to have me around? You could have been in here trying to rub one out for all I know. I don't think that was a very nice thing I just did. Now I'm going to rifle through your shit, too.
Oh, no. I didn't realize how bad Chloe's injury really was.
Really? You didn't? Mayor Mr. and Mrs. Price, as we discussed last week, Chloe's respiratory system is showing rapid signs of weakening. This accounts for her recent anemia and loss of breath. As a doctor, I'm committed to her well-being, but I want you to understand that reality that respirator failure is common in people with severe spinal injuries. Your daughter is one of the bravest, strongest patients I've ever had, and I'm proud to be working with her. I just want you as parents to prepare for any and all possibility. I believe Chloe should also be made aware of her changing condition. If you'd like to discuss this further, you have my contact information. Okay, so Chloe is effectively doomed. So what we've learned now is it's actually not a choice between William and Chloe being paralyzed. It's actually a choice of William being dead or Chloe being dead. We gotta pick one.
Look at them. They have no idea what's in their future.
Just like literally every other human who has ever existed.
That is such a sweet shot of Chloe. I wonder who took the picture.
Me? Maybe? Maybe I took it. And just don't remember, because I don't remember my old future.
William is trying
my different
so
future.
He's still awesome.
He's still awesome, but you know what? I kind of liked him better when he was dead, and there was a potential for me and Chloe to go for a little horizontal mambo.
Huh. Joyce used to hate smokers in the diner.
Yeah, well, habits will change. Sometimes you got to do whatever you can to find
Joyce
a little relaxation.
Joyce is already a super mom.
Who's Dr. Bill?
Good morning, Max. Oh, you and Chloe are so much quieter now than when you were kids.
Yeah, it's hard to run around and cause a ruckus when your legs don't work.
Waking up in your house again.
Oh, William and I love it. Finally seeing you and Chloe together after all these years.
Why were Chloe and I estranged in this past? What happened? Somebody elaborate on that for me.
I wish I was a better friend. I know Chloe doesn't get many visitors.
Oh, Max, you're Chloe's best friend for a reason. You're here exactly when she needs you.
How come none of these people judge me for being a shit friend? At least one of these people should do. One of you should have the balls to stand up to me and be like, yeah, you know what? You behave like kind of a bitch, Max. You were being kind of a bitch, avoiding your friend in her time of need. That's a dick move. Chloe needs help.
Who helps Chloe out when you guys are at work?
We have a series of revolving nurses and caretakers. Chloe still causes trouble, even if she can't move. Max, Chloe's condition is not improving. Her respiratory system is very weak, and she... Do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I read the letter.
Joyce, I'm so sorry you have to go through all this.
Don't worry, though. I'm going to fix it. I'm going to save Chloe, but I'm going to kill your husband. Are you cool with that?
This is what it means to be a family.
If it's any condolences, you know, when William is dead, you will remarry, Joyce. Just the guy you're going to marry is kind of an asshole.
I have to tell you how much I love seeing you and William together again.
Hope you enjoyed it too, because I'm going to go back in time and re-kill him.
Chloe and I are lucky to have him.
Well, you are lucky, but,
Chloe and William
luck runs out.
Still get along so good.
Yeah, so well, Max. They get along so well. Adverb there. You need an adverb.
To William, well, she usually ignores me. Oh, it's so cute when they gang up on poor old me.
You rule, Joyce.
Shit. Things would be different if I did. I like how you think, kid.
How are you doing, Joyce? Oh, gosh, she went full Joey Tribbiani on her.
I won't lie. It's difficult, but nobody said life was easy here in Arcadia Bay.
Yeah, this town is some kind of shit vortex of misery, actually. Everybody in this town is a run-down, beat-up sack. I mean, Arcadia Bay is like the center of the dystopia.
Plus,
it's a vortex of a crap sack universe just waiting to explode.
Bill and I have no time for ourselves. We're working more than we're living. I even had to take a part-time gig at Pan Estates. Ugh.
Do you know the Prescotts?
I know that Sean Prescott won't be happy until he owns everything in Arcadia Bay.
Well, he should be happy pretty soon, because he basically already does.
Nathan.
Do you know about David Madsen? David Madsen? He, might hang out at the Two Wheels.
Well, that was random. Yeah, he's a bus driver. He comes in sometimes. Cute, quiet. Why?
Ever considered taking him as a lover?
Curious.
You always were. Nice to see that everything doesn't change.
Yeah, you know, I was just making the plus ka change reference back when I was in the bathroom. But, speaking of which, you should buy
what
a mop,
do you think
Joyce.
What's going on here with all of this?
Some scouring pads, little calcium lime and rust remover.
To be left alone. I know the feeling. Honestly, I don't give a shit about too much outside our house.
I don't blame you, Joyce.
Except now we have dead birds and beach whales outside our front door.
Yeah, it seems to be common to both the realities I'm currently working on.
For Chloe's sake.
Not the whales, but the dead
birds. I better get back to Chloe now. It's good talking with you, Joyce.
You too, honey.
You know, I was just talking to you the other day when you were still sort of happily remarried and your daughter wasn't paralyzed and your first husband, well, I mean, he was still dead, but things seem generally better in my old past. I'm going to go try and get back to it now. Speaking of which, Max, how come you're still not making any efforts to go back to your old future? Which was definitely better. If only because the, you know, possibility of hot, sweaty, naked monkey love with Chloe still existed. Not that you couldn't go for some hot, sweaty, naked monkey love with Chloe as it stands, but, I mean, it's not like she's going to get much out of it.
Bonjour. That's great they finally went to Paris.
Did they? Oh, am I supposed to talk to William about Paris now?
Hello again, William.
Nice to see you back.
Tell me about your Paris trip.
So you finally made it to Paris.
Nope.
As they say. Not me, because I can't speak French. But it was a great experience.
Oh, Chloe got to go to Paris.
I can see her loving it there. You guys rock for going on a family adventure like that.
Yeah, drove us even deeper in debt, and now we're going to have to pull the plug on Chloe, but, you know.
It's not fair, Max.
I have to go see if Chloe needs anything. It was so great talking with you again.
You know, for like the last time ever, because I'm going to go re-kill you now.
Please, keep me from these bills whenever you want.
No, that's fine. Don't worry about the bills. You're going to have no worries about those. You're going to be worrying about the worms that are gnawing on your entrails. Because I'm seriously going to go re-kill you now.
This is just for Chloe's basic supplies.
We get it, Max. Medicine is very expensive. Yes, we all know. All right. We got your shot, Chloe. Let's get this injected into you as quickly as possible. You know, if you're having respiratory difficulties, though, should we be administering morphine to you? Because that is a respiratory inhibitor. It's going to drive down your respiratory drive even further.
Finally. Give me the blue pill. I'm sorry. I'm nosy, but not precise. Go ahead and plug it right in. It's so easy. And painless.
It's going to sound like a strange question, Chloe, but shouldn't most things be painless for you?
I will. Of course, my pain just keeps getting worse. But you caught me on a good day. Max, I'm so grateful that I'm even able to hang out with you. See, I'm getting mushy.
Or you're just getting doped up on morphine. Okay, well, that's self-acknowledgement. That's fine.
Do you want anything else? Stop me if I'm being too emo, but can you grab one of the photo albums over there? I'd like to check out some old pictures of us when we were kids.
Yeah, just pull on the old heartstrings. That's fine.
Emo ground zero. plus Max Caulfield does not pass up a photo op with Chloe Price. Ever.
Maybe you should take a photo of you and Chloe in this dystopian future that has come about, and then go into that photo and fucking undo it. You ever consider that? This is what got us into this mess in the first place here, Max. Maybe this also is what can get us the hell out of it.
Chloe has her own photo album.
And back to the sweet possibilities of jungle loving with our blue-haired beauty. I want the jungle love, girl. You want the jungle love more than I do. Okay, we gotta take a... At the end of this, we have to take a picture. You and me. Time wizarding. And then I can unwrap this noodle.
Perfect.
And then maybe unwrap your noodle, oh, if you God. Know what I mean. Oh, it doesn't really work, though, because you don't really have a noodle.
Like toys. I remember that day by the lighthouse.
My dad was pissed at us. He actually tried to give us a timeout.
And you laughed.
Yeah, we just laughed and threw rocks at him.
Me.
Let's turn the page, then.
Whoa, awesome picture. We look so badass in our pirate gear.
We should have taken over Arcadia Bay when we had the chance.
Yar, there still be time, matey. Hoist the mainsail. Yeah, you should probably turn that page, Max, because if you're waiting for Chloe to chip in and flip one over, I think it's going to be a long wait.
Oh, man. There we are making pancakes. I love that shot of us.
Ah, yes. If only...
It's hard to believe my dad took that picture.
We could go back to that one, into that picture.
Literally seems like
yesterday.
You know,
minutes before William died. And then we could undo that and make him be dead again.
Maybe I could...
Yeah, I'm definitely going to make him be dead again with no regrets.
Listen, Max. My respiratory system is failing, and it's only getting worse. I've heard the doctors talking about it when they thought I was zonked out.
Also, I read that letter.
I know I'm just putting off the inevitable while my parents suffer along. And I will too. This isn't how I want things to end.
Please don't ask me to murder you, Chloe.
What are you saying?
Do not ask me to kill you.
I'm saying that being with you again has been so special. I just wanted to feel like when we were kids running around Arcadia Bay and everything was possible.
Now she's going to ask me to murder her. I'm not going to do it. I am not going to pull the plug on you, Chloe.
I want this time with you to be my last memory. Do you understand?
Yeah, I'm not going to do it. I am not fucking unplugging you. For one thing, I would fucking definitely go to jail.
Let's crank up the IV to 11.
Why would it go to 11? I am not fucking killing you. I'm not doing it. No, I'm not doing it.
Chloe.
I'm not killing my best friend.
It wrecks me to see you in any pain, but I don't have any right to do this.
Yeah, I'm not murdering my best friend.
I'm giving you the right.
But Joyce and William.
I already said my goodbyes to them, but they won't honor my wishes. You will, right?
Nope.
I can't kill you with an overdose.
Max, I'm dying from my illness, not my dosage. This accelerates the process.
Seriously, I'm not doing this. No.
I'd rather go out on a wave than a rock. And I want my best friend to help me out.
I am going to help you, but not like that.
Exactly. I'm a fucking time wizard, Chloe. I have saved you from far more painful and tragic deaths than this.
Like everybody else.
You're right. I'm gonna go. I'm gonna go back into the past and undo this.
Since you got here, right? So go and don't come back.
Oh, don't lash out just because you didn't get what you wanted.
Chloe, I am never leaving you again.
Well, I'm leaving you specifically to go back to old Chloe because I kind of feel like I'm due for an upgrade. Honestly, though, I'm only in need of an upgrade because I sunk us into this mess in the first place. So now it's up to me to fucking undo this shit.
I'm sorry, William.
Yeah, you gotta die, William. You know what? I think William would probably be okay with this. If you went to any reasonable parent and said, hey, you gotta die so your kid would live, any good parent fucking takes the bullet. William's gonna be, he's gonna be happy that we did this. So we gotta focus this bad boy. Oh, it's in a different spot than it was last time. Well, here we got it. There it goes. And we're gonna go back to Pancake Day, and this time we're gonna hand William the keys and say, here you go! Computers.
I hope the flash didn't scare you, Max. This is a keeper.
It is, in fact, a keeper. Also, your last known photo. I mean, it's not the last known photo of you. That was some previously taken
Hello?
Photo, but that's still your last
hey,
known
honey.
Photo.
What? Oh, I didn't know you had to get groceries. Of course I'll come pick you up.
That way, Chloe will have a reason to hate you forever, you know, because you're the one who called your husband for forgetting your keys.
You mean your college fund? Keys, please.
Time to go find the keys for William.
You can't hide from me forever.
Also, you should consider burning that photo. Okay, good call, Max. Good work with the photo and the burning.
Don't blow it, because tonight your mother promised to make us a world-famous salmon surprise with chocolate cake for dessert.
Yeah, I don't think we're going to be having much of an appetite later, William, if you, you know.
That makes all of us.
Yep. Probably not going to be that hungry. More, you know, grief-stricken. Why is Max so... You didn't do anything!
Max,
you undid
so
a terrible thing! You should be feeling good right now.
Chloe.
You let fate take its
so
natural
sorry.
Course instead of mucking with it.
I tried to make things different for you. I did try.
Yep, but I only
I'm
made
sorry.
It worse.
I don't know exactly what you're talking about, but come on. You have made things different, like my whole life. You're my best friend.
And also, you just fixed my entire future so that I didn't wind up begging you to kill me.
And when we grow up, we're taking over the world.
Listen, whatever happens, I want you to be strong.
Yeah, see, now this is just coming off weird.
You feel like I wasn't there for you. Because I will never abandon you, Chloe.
Except, you know, when I abandon you and then come back later.
Always.
It's a brief abandonment. And here's the one reason why we're definitely one to unwind this future. This future never gets to happen. And sure, there were some great moments and some tragic moments. And now William is dead again. But the one thing and the most important thing, I was never friends with fucking Victoria. That bitch, I will hate her forever. And if I can, I'm gonna kill her. I'm never gonna be your friend. I feel bad about Warren and Brooke, though. I did undo that. But hey, at least the cute, quiet bus driver guy still gets a little bit of booty. Sure, he's gonna smack Chloe upside the head, but again, what's a smack to the face compared to, you know, functional lower body? Is that Chloe and Rachel? Okay, I get it, flashback. Sorted. I remember these things. I just played the game here. I know what happens. You don't have to keep showing me all the memories that are now back in place and all of the ones that I burned. I did this on purpose. I did it deliberate, and I'm comfortable with my decision. I don't need to rewind or time wizard it. I just want to wake up back in my own room without horrible visions of a broken future where Chloe has to try and get me to murder her. I don't want to live in that reality. Neither did William. That's the other thing. William Price would have chosen this too. I can say that with confidence. He loved his daughter. He would have gladly taken a bullet for her. And in this case, that bullet was just shaped like a minivan.
Chloe, you're back.
Whoa, down, Max. You get one kiss, now you're all over me?
Yeah, well, I'm in for seconds if you are, girl.
I'm so glad you're here.
And, you know, not paralyzed.
You sound high. But thanks for the morning grope. Since we were up all night playing CSI Arcadia Bay, I was still spaced out here trying to put all this info together.
I went to a horrible, grim dystopian universe where you were paralyzed, but your dad was dead, and then you begged me to kill you.
I hope you weren't messing around with time while I was sleeping.
I was definitely messing around with time while you were sleeping.
I'm just spaced out, too.
But you're right, not anymore. We've learned what the butterfly effect actually does, and I'm not going to be doing any more of that going into photos to fuck with shit.
I don't think about what happened.
I don't know. I mean, it'd make for a good anecdote, set a story, get real drunk one night, maybe on your wedding night, Max. Be like, hey, remember that time
Let's
I almost paralyzed and killed you?
Let's look at the big board and see all our pieces in the puzzle so far.
Let's look at the big board. Do I... Okay, fine. I mean, we go look at the big board.
I'm getting lost in all this shit.
So I'm just going to sit back down for a minute, because you know what? I've had a hell of a day.
Welcome
I could. I need a minute.
World, Max.
I need a minute to kind of gather myself.
I don't think
around.
I can ever tell Chloe about what happened.
Just rethink the same thought I already have. Okay, you're right. I was correct to stand up here. Let's check out the paper. What's going on in the Great Northwest?
This is a serious expose on the Prescott.
Pan Estates, Heaven or Hell by Craig Kennedy. The name Prescott may not mean much to you or those outside the edges of a small coastal Oregon town, but this is a name that means quite a bit in Arcadia Bay. A quaint town seemingly stuck in time. Once home to a prosperous fishing and tourism industry, the town has seen much better paydays. Despite the local success of prestigious Blackwell Academy and its football and swimming teams, the Bigfoots and the Otters' environmental changes to the area have reduced the amount of fish and other sea life, resulting in a stagnant economy and limited tourism. Oddly, the Prescotts have managed to keep their business interests quite profitable. In fact, they're behind an expensive exclusive housing development known as Pan Estates, to be built in the deep forest near Blackwell Academy. Local Native American groups have already filed various motions against the development, citing widespread destruction of tribal lands and natural resources. So not only are Nathan Prescott's parents yuppies who are paving over the local natural environment and destroying it, they're buried. They're literally building their houses on a fucking ancient Indian burial ground. That really didn't work out that well for the family in Poltergeist, Prescott's. Maybe you should just, you know, keep in mind your classic cinema movies. Or if you're going to do it, at least also move the bodies and not just the headstones. Craig T. Nelson's going to be furious if you don't. The Bad Girl's Guide to Guns by Coffee Greer. And what else have we got to remind us that Chloe is still tragically punk? All right, let's check out the big board then, I guess. Chloe, tragically punk. So we have... I don't know what any of this shit is. Okay, that's a picture of Kate Marsh. That's a picture, so I think, of Max behind the vehicle, away. The wheel of Frank's car.
We have to do three main things.
Right. What things?
We have to cock our hips at a grossly unnatural angle so that it looks like we might shatter our spine.
Get Nathan's phone to find out where he's...
You know how to do that, right, Chloe?
Club parties with Kate and Rachel.
Got it.
And see whatever hidden shit he's got in his messages.
Check.
Three, beat Step Douche Dan until he tells us about Frank, Nathan, and the Dark Room.
I don't know. We already kind of gave David the what's for here.
Keep it in your pants.
Yeah.
We'll have to do this on our own.
Also, Max never encouraged Chloe to keep it in her pants.
Then rewind. Fine, whatevs. It's your power.
What you should be doing is encouraging her to keep it in your pants. Specifically, be like, Chloe, keep it in my pants. By that, I mean your face and or hands.
You didn't even let me take that money to pay Frank off.
And I'm...
You're right. I'm not going to let you steal from the disabled.
I know.
Only recently you would have sympathized with that decision, Chloe.
I'm going to cyberstalk some names and see where that leads. Or to who. And be careful of Stepcrack. He's not going to be a happy camper after you reamed him yesterday and Mom is giving him the boot.
I'm on it, partner.
So wait, what's my goal?
I can't abuse this level of my rewind power. It's way too dangerous, and I need to navigate the present without messing up the past.
I haven't really used my rewind power much at all lately. I've sort of been slacking in the time wizarding department just because I feel like I'm making pretty good decisions the first time out of the box. Just like most people who aren't time wizards should try to do.
That snow dough always makes me think of William and Clark.
It makes me think of John Bambi Doe, ruminant detective, every single time. And to know that some wizard has locked his mother into a horrible glass menagerie makes me very unhappy.
I'm so sorry, William. It's not fair you had to die twice.
It's not fair, that's true. He didn't have to die twice. We could have just left him be dead the first time instead of going back and dicking around with time.
I feel like we're missing a major clue.
Yes, Chloe Price was here.
Yes, Chloe smokes cigarettes. So what? She has an unfortunate habit. Stop being all judgy, Max. Jeez, everybody needs a vice.
Even Holmes and Watson didn't use every piece of information.
Yeah, sometimes Watson ejaculated stuff that wasn't relevant to the plot. Sometimes he just ejaculated when Holmes jerked him off.
To drink lots of coffee.
Wait, is lots of coffee? Is that like, is lots of the brand? We're drinking lots of coffee. Having trouble staying awake? Are you a trucker on a late night overland long haul run? Try lots of coffee. Commercial writes itself.
Known just erasing that phone message wouldn't stop the police.
Okay, too close. Miss Price, this is Officer Anderson Berry, and since we have your contact info on file here, we'd like you to come by the station on Monday morning at approximately 8 a.m. to answer a few questions about information you have regarding a recent break-in at Blackwell Academy. The fact that your car was identified in the parking lot at around the same time. Look forward to clearing this up. Officer Berry, ABPD. Well, that's easy. Just tell them you were there to pick me up from the academy because I snuck out. This is something that gives you a reason to be there. A rational alibi. and is totally not against the law to come pick up your surreptitious girlfriend. That's all you gotta do. Be like, no, I was picking up my girl.
Seems like a million years ago. How much time have I altered since?
I don't know. Not quite enough to keep Kate Marsh's skull from splattering on the pavement. I think maybe we probably would have been served with altering at least a little bit more. Anything else going on over here? Nope. So we're just supposed to leave? Oh, we can talk to Chloe. Let's do that. Let's take a photo of Chloe first. Get a picture of my girl doing her thing. Also, you know what, Chloe? You look better with the tattoo. So we took a secret picture of Chloe? That's a little creepy, Max.
I wish I could tell Chloe how much William cared about her.
Pretty sure she knew. And also, you know what you might try here is telling her how much you care about her, Max. Well, just express your love, Max. There's no shame in it. You love a woman. Tell her you love her. She might love you back. And I mean, not just, you know, in the more generalized sense, but also in like the physical sense.
No.
Like she might literally love you.
The bird has been trapped in here.
I don't think that bird is trapped. Also, the fact that that bird is in here may be the only thing keeping that bird alive. Every bird we've seen outside is dead. Why does the bird have to keep coming in the bathroom and shitting everywhere, though? Shoo, bird. Beat it. The fuck out of the house. Am I supposed to... So that's what I'm supposed to do is just scare the bird away.
Oh, that blue dye makes me so happy. It means the real Chloe is back.
Yeah, and it means that the game really, really, really wants me to come back in here and, like, rifle through another disturbingly filthy bathroom and not forget to splash water on my face because every fucking opportunity. Somebody must have worked really hard on that animation and just been super proud of it.
I wanted to splash some water on my face. My whole life changed.
Well, let's hope that this splash of water will change it back. Also, let's turn the light out in this bathroom and never set foot in here again. You know, if Chloe and I do eventually hook up, get married, get a place together, at some point we're going to have to set down some ground rules about how the bathroom gets cleaned and, like, who does it and how regularly.
This might be the last poster advertising Arcadia Bay after tomorrow night.
Well, we're going to fix it, Max. Calm down.
Since David might be in there, I better mosey along for a change.
You can just open the door and time wizard your way out of trouble, but I don't want to judge. I am trying to get you to cup. Beautiful.
Oh, shit. Poor thing.
Yeah, that's just... Okay. Did you really think that wasn't going to happen, Max? That the bird wasn't going to brain itself on the window? That's how we met the bird in the first place. All right, Blue Jay, you want to fucking beat it
Fly.
Now?
Be free.
Get out of here. Also, I find it hard to believe that the bird got up enough speed to shatter its own skull into, like, 2.5 feet between that bookshelf and the window. Just saying. I'm also not leaving the window open because I don't want the dumb thing flying back in here. It's already, probably by this point, shit all over the entire house. Tired of walking around. I mean, there's enough human feces crusting the bathroom. We don't need to be adding random animal feces as well. Whoops. Awkward. Yep.
You won
He's
this
having
battle,
a moment.
Max. You broke up my family. I salute you.
Yeah, you're going to be
David,
real angry when I try and
I
marry your daughter,
to hurt
too.
You. Ever. But I won't let anybody hurt Chloe.
Yeah, you ever heard that song by Magic? Rude? I'm going to marry that girl. We're going to
be
a family.
Damn careful with her. Don't you wander off into the dark.
I'm not going anywhere. I broke the heart of a veteran. I don't feel good about it. I don't. I really don't. So, what do we do now? I guess we just wander around
yep.
and rifle through
Locked
shit.
Locked from the other side.
What a surprise. Oh, good. Warren wants something. Talk to my parents. They pay the bills. B plus. What up, Max? I got a B plus on my chemistry exam. Yo, yo, Max. Your friend Chloe texted me that I'm out of the loop now. She sounds hot, so I get why. Chloe actually tested you. I sure didn't have her number. Now I get why you didn't want to go ape with me. You should go with Chloe. She looks cool enough for you. I have a lot of cool friends like you. Yes, you do. Just my luck. And mine. Have to jet. Talk to you later. I hope so. Warren has maybe finally caught on to the fact that we are not into Warren. XOXO, and that was no emoji. What's Juliet want? Some of these people I've never even heard of. Who the fuck is Justin? Dad. It's not. I don't like strangers having my number. Okay, wait. What's going on here? Thanks, Pop. Ready to come home. Talk later. Weird text warning. My nosy daughter better stop watching others and look out for herself. This is some kind of school plank, and it's from a block number. Oh, I'm sorry. Some jack kissed my class. Thought it would be funny to send. It's not. I don't like strangers having my number. Okay, me neither. Sorry. I'm just being a dad. I know this has been a tough week for you. It's almost over. I'll call you guys. Love you. All right, Justin, what do you want? Who, Juliet, what do you want? Busy, no time to be, never text me what's going down. Besides everything, I was just curious if you've ever heard of a guy named Frank who lives in an RV around town. You mean a van down by the river? Heard he's a sketchy meth head. That's about it. Why, are you doing an unknown investigation without my help? No, just bored. Talk soon. Thanks. Okay, but you can't keep secrets from ace reporter Juliet Watson, who's been, like, barely a part of the plot. What's Justin want? Sorry, my phone is in my bag. Hey, Justin, you busy? Max Wax, I'm busy blazing. What up? You know Frank Bowers? Drugs. That's it. Ask Nathan. He knows him, I think. Okay, I'm on it. Thanks, Justin. For what? Dude, I just always text people the word drugs. It's funny every time, bro. Okay, good to hear. Call us anytime you need it. Blah, blah, blah. We got it. Yes, I killed my plant, Lisa. Oh, I'm sorry, sweetie. We'll get another. One plant was stressful enough. Now back to the books. Talk soon. Well, at least she was upfront about the murder. Ms. Kaufeld, I want to thank you so much for your actions. My daughter, Kate, your true grace and bravery. You went up to that roof with her. You must know you did all that was possible and that Kate's life was never in your hands or hers. Wait, didn't we already read this? Max, this is Richard Marks again. I want to let you know that Kate's service is next week and our family would like to extend an invitation to you. I know you've been through a lot and we fully understand you if you can't attend. Kate was our special angel and your friendship with her blessed us all. Send you details later today. Again, thank you for being a light in the darkness. Thank you, Mr. Marsh. I absolutely will attend the service. I know my words don't mean much, but I want you to know that Kate is always in my thoughts and always will be. Is that it? Are we done? We good? Okay, we're good. Caught up on all our text messages. They were really piling up. What was William staring
David
at?
David isn't any different from me when he's looking at those family photos.
Okay, same photos we've already looked at. Ooh, TV.
Those poor whales are like beached angels.
Yes, like giant blubbery angels rotting in the noonday sun, as angels are wont to do.
Those poor whales are like beached angels. What is going on here?
No cookies.
Looks like they're back on the road to Paris.
Well, they didn't ever get there the first time, but, you know, they've only got half as many adults earning a living now that William is dead.
Ouch.
David, do not be here when I get back from work. I mean it. Jay Price. Ouch. Yeah, ouch indeed. We got to take ownership on that one. I'm still eating David's half-eaten donut, though. Sorry. Girls got to eat.
I existed in this whole other reality, but I don't know what happened.
You absolutely know what happened. You were there. You lived it. Then you came back to this one.
The more I see how little control I have over what happens.
Pretty much just like everybody else. The trick, Max, is to try and get it right the first time.
Two or maybe three different realities.
Or maybe like a multiverse and an actual infinite number of realities.
I wonder if Chloe would hate me for keeping her alive. But I couldn't do it. Thinking
we
about
done
all
here?
These lifelines almost makes my head hurt worse than the rewind.
I better check and see if your nose is bleeding then. It often does that when you've rewound too much. Are we good? Are you done beating yourself up now? That's the one thing I really feel like Life is Strange has done very well. They have very much captured the sort of like self-doubt that haunts, I guess, every teen girl.
Did I actually cause that clock to stop?
Never having been a teen girl, I really couldn't tell you.
Oh, there's a ladybug stuck in the dials.
Okay. I saved a ladybug.
Time keeps on ticking.
No, Max. Time keeps on slipping into the future. Steve Miller Band.
To think this all started with my vision of a tornado.
Yeah, to think that it all started with a vision of a tornado that was like a mere couple hours ago. I'm not even going to read that article. We've rifled through everything in this house so many dozens of times already. Is there anything left to rifle? What could we possibly have in this place that's unrifled?
Maybe there's some new clues around.
New clues. Sure. Really, what I'm looking for, Max, is just a save point. That's what I'd like to find. If you could find a spot that would save the game, be good. I'd kind of like to rack up the episode here.
What the hell did David do for Nathan?
Mr. Madsen, thank you for your help with Nathan. David? It is appreciated. Best S. Prescott. Okay.
Either Chloe stole another gun, or David is out there armed.
Probably, I'm going to guess, the latter as opposed to the former, and he's probably looking for some payback.
Jeez. David is packing up wedding stuff, too.
Let's check out William's stuff.
That makes me sad. It was so incredible to see William again. I wish Chloe could, too.
I don't. The last time Chloe got to see him again, she wound up begging us to kill her.
He should finish this letter to Joyce.
Joyce, you know I'm not good at explaining myself or why I act the way I do sometimes. I only know that nobody has ever understood me the way you do. I would never do anything to hurt you or Chloe. Taking care of my family is my number one mission. Yes, I overstepped bounds with the surveillance and suspicion, and I'm truly sorry and ashamed, but there are dark things happening in Arcadia Bay I've never told you. You are my wife and partner, and I know we would... Man, William has terrible handwriting. I know we should have no secrets. I intended to tell you everything, but I wanted more proof. Instead, a student committed suicide on my watch. You kicked me out of my favorite home, and my stepdaughter hates me. Please let me something. Or just please let me not finish my letter. Emails?
Should I have signed the petition? Blackwell sure isn't safe.
Despite a rather heated discussion about the successful petition to block camera surveillance system, I'm still interested in your feedback on other methods of improving Blackwell security. Let's find a middle ground between safety and privacy for our students. Best principal ass fucker. Principal pig fuck. Never letting this guy live down what he did to alternate Chloe.
Oh, meow, Ms.
Principal
Grant.
Pig fuckers.
Twist that knife.
I don't need a surveillance camera to see the suspension coming. Best of luck to you, Mrs. Grant. Ow, what a bitch.
At least he has one weird fan.
Dear Mr. Manson, I just wanted to let you know I think it's bullshit what happened to you, and the school has too many libtard metrosexuals who don't appreciate you or the military. I felt safe in my dorm when you were in charge, and I thought about you protecting me. I hope you will come back to Blackwell and make sure we are all safe at night. I am scared of this school.
Wish I had surveillance footage of that conversation.
I apologize for my output yesterday in your office. I was upset about losing my position at Blackwell without a complete investigation of the facts and based solely on the claims of untrustworthy students. There's a cancer at Blackwell Academy. Without me, it will continue to spread. Sincerely, Madsen D. So cancer's Nathan Prescott, Victoria, and the Vortex Club.
David must be working for the Prescotts, too.
Man, guy's double-dipping. He's moonlighting. Principal Wells is going to be furious. He's got a second job and didn't tell Wells anything about it. Then again, I have it on good authority that that guy is a pig fucker, so who cares?
Whoa, that is a serious padlock on that locker. Hey, David, what you hiding?
Oh, you know, guns, ammo, the usual. Dead hooker. How are we going to find the code here? Yeah.
For once, I don't have time to search for the code. Oh, I need to find a way to break this padlock.
Okay. So crowbar, screwdriver, any of those kind of things looking around? What do we got?
Oh, look at the baby blue jay eggs in the nest. I better move his plank if I want to. Oh.
Yeah, come on. That's fine.
Blue jay eggs in the nest.
So the bird lived here long enough to build a fucking nest and lay eggs.
Excuse me. Just one picture, please.
Unbelievable. This is the dirtiest house we have ever seen. They have a bird nesting in their garage. Come on, people.
Another photo from my Arcadia Bay wildlife series.
Yep, truly an everyday hero, Max. By the way, how's your contest entrance coming? You know what? I don't really care. We actually managed to find a save point. We're going to pick this up later. This episode's gone on long enough. A bird living in your house. Joyce is like the worst housekeeper of all time. Or alternatively, David. I don't want to get all heteronormative on the gender roles here. Maybe David's in charge of cleaning up the place. Whoever's in charge of it, though, they're doing a fucking terrible job. Just abominable. If you enjoyed the episode, feel free to drop a like down in the comment section. Of course, your support does really mean a lot to us. And if you'd like to see the continuing adventures of our unfucked timeline and our quest to refuck the delightfully blue-haired Chloe, you might consider subscribing as well. New episodes of Life is Strange every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. Right now, thanks very much for watching. I'll see you again soon.